ever been with a group of people that became silent that quickly. That was everything. Representatives of federal, state, and local government, veterans, active servicemen and women in attendance, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Rockaway Township Mayor and Council, American Legion Post 344, and the Planning Committee for this event, I thank you for being here. My name is Peter Tabbitt, and I'm Health Officer with Rockaway Township, with the Division of Health and the Department of Community Services, and I'm thrilled to be Master of Ceremonies for this very special event. As we honor a man, a resident of Rockaway Township, whose distinguished service, heroism, and extraordinary efforts literally helped preserve the very identity of millions of people for us to study, share, and sustain. I would ask you at this time that you join me, please, in a Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Harry Ettlinger's story and his work have become very special to me. Like some of you, I consider myself a patron of the arts, inasmuch as a public servant can be. Like others in attendance, I'm a descendant of numerous European Jews who died at the hands of Nazis and Hitler's Final Solution, and I do have familial ties to some of history's most awful atrocities. Like some among you, I care about cultural preservation and provenance when it comes to the theft of art and the rightful ownership of same. And like all of you, I am absolutely fascinated with the life and accomplishments of Mr. Harry Ettlinger. Harry's narrative is the kind of story that seemingly only a Hollywood screenwriter could conceive, and one that can only be done justice with a blockbuster film and a chapter in a best-selling book or two. Harry's unique life and accomplishments do, in fact, make their way into a feature film, multiple documentaries, and numerous books. And his work in helping save antiquities and artifacts representing entire cultures is not only compelling, but the very essence of humanity. Born Heinz Ludwig Chaim Ettlinger in Karlsruhe, Germany in 1926, Harry grew up a German Jew under growing Nazi oppression in the 1930s. His family, once affluent and well-respected in the community, became ostracized. The Ettlinger's very successful business, specializing in elegant women's fashions, was first boycotted and then closed. Common freedoms were stripped away, and the Ettlingers had no choice but to flee the country in 1938 if they wished to live, as the Nazis' ultimate plans became imminent. And they did so one day after Harry's bar mitzvah, making it to the United States and settling in Newark, New Jersey. About 6 years later, Harry was drafted into the United States Army. He was assigned to the 99th Infantry Division and was sent off to join a counterattack in the Battle of the Bulge. As Harry waited in a vehicle with a handful of his fellow soldiers, he was mysteriously pulled from the transit. It turns out that Harry's fluency in German, an immense asset, was to place him at the Nuremberg war trials as an interpreter. While in Munich awaiting this assignment, Harry offered his services to the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives effort, and soon found himself translating testimony from Hitler's personal photographer. Shortly thereafter, Harry was assigned to help supervise underground operations at the Nazi repository in Heilbronn, Koppendorf salt mines. The underground mines had been utilized by the Nazis to protect museum treasures, as well as for the building of jet engine parts by Hungarian Jewish slave laborers from concentration camps. The first priority for the monuments men was to return 73 cases containing stained glass belonging to the Strasbourg Cathedral in France, on orders directly from General Dwight D. Eisenhower. Harry's tenure with the monuments men would continue a year and a half, whereas many involved in this effort were reassigned within just a few months. Harry Ettlinger is, in fact, one of only five surviving members of the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives effort, a group originally of 345 men and women from 13 countries that worked tirelessly to recover and return the cultural treasures stolen by the Nazis during World War II. The Monuments Men, as they became known, recovered as many as 5 million individual works of art and artifacts worth billions of dollars today, which the Nazis had confiscated from museums, houses of worship, and rightful owners. The Nazis' theft of priceless works of art, religious artifacts, and cultural heritage was unprecedented in the history of international conflict. By helping assure the reclamation, restoration, and preservation of the very objects that define cultures, the extraordinary men and women of the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives Initiative preserved the richness of European culture for generations to come. Harry Ettlinger and the Monuments Men did more, perhaps, for cultural preservation than any other group or initiative of the 20th centuries. As Harry has said himself, That's what made our war different. It established the policy that to the victor do not go the spoils. The whole idea of returning property to its rightful owners in wartime was unprecedented. Though Harry's most enduring accomplishments took place with the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives effort, his fascinating story is not limited to the work of this important international collective. After the war effort and the continued work of the Monuments Men in the 1940s, Harry went on to earn master's degrees in mechanical engineering and business administration before becoming deputy program director for a company that produced guided systems for submarine-launched nuclear weapons. Today, Harry co-chairs the Wallenberg Foundation of New Jersey, named for a wealthy Swedish-born Protestant who inspired others to help him rescue approximately 100,000 Hungarian Jews from the Holocaust. The organization empowers young people to positively affect society with their individual actions. Harry is also active with the leadership of several local and regional veterans organizations, and at the tender age of 88, Harry remains engaged, dedicated to volunteerism, and committed to advocacy. Harry Ettlinger is the genuine article. He is able to speak freely about the abject horror of growing up as a Jewish child in Nazi Germany during the late 1930s, yet he is somehow able to reminisce with fondness, not terror or melancholy, about his neighborhood, his father's art collection, his family's hugely successful business, and he is also able to recall the ways in which he was all stripped away, stolen from him and those around him. And he does this without malice or contempt, but with understanding, calmness, and resolve. Harry truly is a remarkable man, and the story of his life is remarkable as well. Before introducing our first guest, I'd like to take this opportunity to recognize a number of individuals who've made this evening possible. First would be the planning committee for this event. Whether it was the rental of the venue, publicity, partnering with our military community, brainstorming, and of course supporting the event itself, these individuals have helped plan and implement tonight's tribute. So a big thanks go to Gregory Hoff, Rockaway Township's business administrator. Where's Gregory? Joe Fiorella, Department of Community Services Director. Rich Marino and Bob de Blasi of American Legion Post 344. Captain Marty McFarland of the Rockaway Township Police Department, who also is a wonderful chauffeur. John Donato from the Historical Society of Rockaway Township. And Chris Kunkel and Eric Kowal of Picatinny Arsenal. On behalf of this planning committee, I would like to extend a very special thank you to William Alsea and George Knapp of AMC Rockaway 16 Theaters, who have made every conceivable accommodation for us. They have truly embraced this event, and they've been working with us since September of 2013 to provide anything we could have needed. So we thank them for their amazing help and their interest. Thank you also to our friends at Picatinny Arsenal, represented tonight by Lieutenant Colonel Jason McKay and Command Sergeant Major Rosalba Dumont Carrion. Thank you for being with us this evening and for helping me. Thank you for helping us maintain a wonderful partnership with Rockaway Township. We also wish to thank Sony Pictures for their very kind support of this event. We have some special items to give away before tonight's movie presentation, thanks in part to Sony, so please remain seated as we get ready to show the film. Another thank you is due actually to Jamie Brighton of the Rockaway Township Division of Health. Jamie happened to meet Harry while doing routine work for the township, and it's likely that we would not be gathered here tonight if Jamie had not started a dialogue in our department about honoring Harry. So thank you, Jamie. And a very, very, very tremendous thanks are due to the leadership of American Legion Post 344 for so generously supporting this event. All of the veterans and active servicemen and women in attendance tonight received complimentary admission because of the American Legion Post 344's underwriting of this event. And words cannot express the community's gratitude for the Legion's commitment to our veterans and active military. In particular, Bob de Blasi, Rich Marino, and Commander Russ, we appreciate your help with everything you've done for this event, so thank you so much. Finally, a very special thank you to Joe Fiorella. He's gonna get shy. But aside from being probably the most resourceful person in Rockaway Township, Joe has been my partner in helping coordinate this event. Joe is a student of history and the United States military, and I know that my enthusiasm in paying tribute to Harry Ettlinger, our veterans and active military attendance, is perhaps only exceeded by his. So thank you, Joe, for all you've done in helping make this event happen. This evening, we are honoring Harry Ettlinger, but we also wish to recognize our men and women in uniform, our veterans and those serving actively at this moment, who have sacrificed so much on our behalf. We're honored and humbled to have among us nearly 100 veterans and active servicemen and women. On behalf of our grateful community, I would like to ask if all the active military attendants would please stand up to be recognized. I would now ask that all of our veterans in attendance please take a moment to stand and be recognized, and please remain standing. I would like to take a moment and ask the veterans in attendance who are active during Operation Desert Storm or later to please be seated. Those veterans active during or after the U.S. invasion of Grenada, roughly 1983, if you could please be seated. Veterans of the war in Vietnam, if you could please be seated. Any veterans whose service dates back to the Korean War, please be seated. Finally, if you served our country during World War II, please remain standing a moment. Please join me in recognizing the veterans in attendance. On behalf of this evening's host from the Township and American Legion Post 344, we thank our veterans and active servicemen and women for all you've done and for all you do. Speaking of support for our veterans, our first distinguished guest is a good friend of Rockaway Township and has spent the last 45 years supporting the United States military. Having served with the United States Army during the Vietnam War, Congressman Ronnie Frelinghuysen has long advocated for our veterans and active military. Congressman Frelinghuysen is chairman of the House Defense Appropriations Subcommittee, has secured funds to expand VA services for local veterans, and has championed the work of our vital military institutions, most notably Picatinny Arsenal. Congressman Frelinghuysen is also a member of American Legion Post 59 and a life member of the Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 3401. From the 11th Congressional District, we welcome Congressman Ronnie Frelinghuysen.
To be here at the home of Picatinny Arsenal, and let me echo a lot of what Peter said in recognizing the service and sacrifice of those who serve in Afghanistan. If I look a little bit tired, I actually, at 8 o'clock last night, just got back from Afghanistan. And let me tell you that you can be very proud of those who serve in Afghanistan today doing the work of freedom. And they're not alone, because we obviously have soldiers and Marine and airmen and people from the Navy and all of our services serving around the world doing the work of freedom. Let me say also to Post 344, thank you for your leadership. You also make some very good pancakes, so I like those. And let me say to Mayor Datchison and the council, this didn't come together without obviously some leadership from the top and from the bottom. And let me say, I've known Harry Ettlinger since the 1980s, and it's an honor to be here with you, Harry. Let me say on behalf of a grateful nation, I want to thank you for being one of the greatest of the greatest generation, and for your incredible work as a monument man, saving priceless works of art, and really doing things on behalf of the world, preserving its treasures. We honor you. You are a treasure. Thank you.
Thank you. go down, Harry?
Yeah, we're going to bring Harry down.
God bless you.
Thank you very, very, very much, William.
We're going to put Harry right here in the hot seat for a few. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Harry Ettlinger. We're going to have Harry speak with us in a few minutes, but I want to thank Congressman Frelinghuysen, and I knew that you had just flown in from a long international trip, and we really appreciate you being with us this evening. And again, not hollow words, we know how you support Picatinny and the Veterans and Active Military. I would now like to introduce Mr. Charles Burton, advisor to United States Senator Robert Menendez. Senator Menendez, who's the 2008 recipient of the Outstanding Federal Legislator of the Year Award from the Veterans of Foreign Wars Department of New Jersey, regrets that he can't be with us tonight. It may surprise some of you to learn that Senator Menendez knows Harry Ettlinger and has been seeking the highest civilian honor for the Monuments Men. In 2013, Senator Menendez, along with Senator Roy Blunt from Missouri, introduced bipartisan legislation that would award the Congressional Gold Medal to Harry and his Monuments Men colleagues. The Congressional Gold Medal, along with the Presidential Medal of Freedom, is the highest civilian honor in the United States. On behalf of the United States, Senator Robert Menendez, it's my pleasure to introduce Charles Burton.
Thank you, Peter. I just have brief remarks on behalf of Senator Menendez, who is in Washington tonight and apologizes for not being able to be here. The senator asked me to come here tonight and present the proclamation which we have up here on his behalf, on behalf of the people of the state of New Jersey, to applaud Harry Ettlinger for his heroic work and service to not only the United States Army, but also to the cultural heritage of Europe. We're pleased to present this proclamation to you and honor you for all of your work, all of your sacrifices for all of us and our freedom. Congratulations.
It's pretty hard to keep Harry seated. I'm telling you, he's more active than I am. Now from our 26th Legislative District, I'm very pleased to introduce two more good friends of Rockaway Township, Assemblywoman Betty Lou DeCroche and Senator Joseph Panaccio, who bring greetings and a joint resolution from our state legislature.
Thank you, Harry, and all of our past, present, and future soldiers. I told Harry he was a good-looking guy when he was young. I think the guy actually went to his head. Anyway, thank you all of our soldiers for your past service. Art is important because it defines us and separates us from other species that God created. It's hard to imagine that the same species of humans that gave us Harry Ettlinger would also supply us with evil men who would seek to destroy other men, women, and children. The same human race that gave us the Monument Men also produced the Nazis and the Gestapo. The same human race that had their hands on the weapons of mass destruction, hands that locked the doors to concentration camps and gas chambers, also produced hands that gave us precious art that would outlive evil and be a testament to the human spirit and all that is good and can be good within the family of man. Thank you, Harry, and all of our soldiers for helping to preserve that. God bless you, Harry.
And for me, I'm the lucky one that was kissed by Harry tonight.
Twice,
you're right. And also, I'm very fortunate to be able to read to you the joint legislative resolution from the Senate and General Assembly of the State of New Jersey. Whereas the Senate and General Assembly of the State of New Jersey are pleased to honor and salute Harry Ettlinger, a highly esteemed resident of Rockaway Township, Morris County. Upon the occasion of the special movie screening of The Monuments Men on February 24, 2014 at AMC Rockaway 16 Theaters, and where Harry Ettlinger settled in the United States in 1938 after being forced to leave Germany, and he served this country with honor and valor in the United States Army 99th Infantry Division during World War II before being assigned to what would become known as the Monument Men effort, and whereas Harry Ettlinger is one of just nine surviving members of the Monuments Men effort, and where a praiseworthy and worthwhile endeavor undertaken by 350 individuals from 13 countries to recover and return cultural treasures stolen by the Nazis. And whereas Harry Ettlinger served with distinction as a deputy program director for a company that produced guided systems from submarine-based nuclear weapons, and he currently lends his wisdom and expertise as a co-chair of the Wallenberg Foundation of New Jersey, which I'm proud to say that's how I know Harry, from the Wallenberg Foundation. Whereas Harry Ettlinger's exemplary dedication and steadfast commitment have earned for him the respect and admiration of all who know him, and have set a standard toward which others might strive. And whereas it is both proper and fitting for the legislature to pause in deliberation to commend Harry as a man of outstanding character and exceptional determination, now therefore be it resolved by the Senate and General Assembly of the State of New Jersey that this legislature hereby joins the citizens of this state, this country, and the world in honoring Harry Ettlinger, pays tribute to his courageous and noteworthy efforts, and extends to him sincere best wishes. Be it further resolved that a duly authenticated copy of this resolution, signed by the Senate President and Assembly Speaker, and attested by the Senate Secretary and the Assembly Clerk, be transmitted to Harry Ettlinger.
Sorry, Harry, I'm verbose. Thank you, Senator Panaccio and Assemblywoman DeCroce, for bringing well wishes from our state legislature. And now with a very special presentation for Harry, we're honored to have with us, from the New Jersey National Guard, Captain Ryan Hardy and First Sergeant John Rowe, and from the New Jersey Department of Military and Veterans Affairs, Deputy Commissioner Raymond Zawacki.
On behalf of New Jersey, the State of New Jersey, and the Department of Military and Veterans Affairs, let me thank you for the invitation to be with you this evening. I am joined this evening by Captain Ryan Hardy, who will assist me in making this presentation to Harry Ettlinger. It's not every day that we get an opportunity to make a presentation like we are about to make here. Certainly, we award a number of distinguished service medals to individuals throughout the year. However, to award one to a World War II veteran who has had such a positive impact on history, not only for the state of New Jersey, not only for the United States of America, but indeed for the world, is truly an honor. And it gives me a great deal of pleasure to make this presentation this evening. I'm going to call on Captain Hardy to read the citation while I pin the medal on Harry.
Attention to orders. The State of New Jersey Distinguished Service Medal is awarded to Technician 4th Grade, Harry L. Ettlinger. The governor of the state of New Jersey, Chris Christie, under the authority of 38 Alpha 15-2, New Jersey revised statutes, awards a distinguished service medal to technician 4th grade, Harry L. Ettlinger, for distinguished meritorious service in ground operations during World War II in the European, African, Middle Eastern Theater of Operations. Signed, Governor Chris Christie. Wow.
Thank you, Deputy Commissioner Zawacki, Captain Hardy, and First Sergeant Rowe for honoring Harry with distinguished service medal, acknowledging him on behalf of the state of his service. My understanding is that the medal was created in 1858 to recognize those who distinguished themselves as members of the New Jersey Militia, and was reauthorized by Governor Keene in 1988, and we're certainly grateful that the governor did so today. And now, bringing Harry wishes and congratulations from the Morris County Board of Chosen Freeholders, it is my pleasure to introduce Deputy Director David Scapicchio and Hank Lyon, the latter of whom, when he joined the Freehold Board in 2012, was the state's youngest freeholder.
We also have Freeholder John Krikus here. John, why don't you come on down? And we are here representing the Morris County Board of Chosen Freeholders. And we have a resolution here that I'll read honoring Harry. During World War II, the Nazi Army was relentless in its pillaging the finest art in Europe in an attempt to fulfill Adolf Hitler's dream of transforming his hometown of Linz, Austria, into a cultural capital. And in 1943, President Franklin D. Roosevelt and General Dwight D. Eisenhower created the Monuments, Fine Arts and Archives program to halt the thefts. And more than 350 military and civilian men and women from 13 nations filled the ranks of this program and became known as the Monuments Men, whose mission was to protect, rescue, and retrieve stolen masterpieces and save historical churches and monuments. And among the soldiers taking part in this hunt was Harry Ettlinger, a German Jew who escaped Germany with his family in 1938, immigrated to the United States, became a U.S. citizen, was drafted into the Army, and returned to Europe as an infantryman, and was reassigned to the Monuments Men. And he and other men and women of the Monuments Men, at great personal peril, crisscrossed war-torn European countries, tracked, located, and returned millions of stolen fine art and cultural items, and he's truly deserving of this recognition. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Board of Chosen Freeholders, Morris County, New Jersey, congratulates and offers its sincere appreciation to Harry Ettlinger for his heroic and unprecedented work to protect and to preserve from the destruction of World War II countless cultural artistic treasures while serving as one of the Monuments Men. Harry, congratulations. My pleasure to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you. We appreciate you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Now bringing greetings from a township organization that the Department of Community Services works very closely with, the Historical Society of Rockaway Township, Society President Stephen Dopniak.
Thank you.
Any better?
I'm here with you today because so few professions leave so indelible mark on our lives. While we honor our fallen heroes and remember our servicemen and women serving here and overseas, We have an opportunity today to pay homage to a veteran still with us. As historians, this particular episode in history hits home for my group and I especially. That a group of men and women from different countries in a race against time were tasked to retrieve, protect, and eventually return these international treasures to their place of origin. Although we are all mortal, this courageous act will ensure that future generations will have the opportunity to appreciate these works of art. And I hope that they will remember those men and women who risked their lives to save them. So, on behalf of the Historical Society of Rockaway Township, we'd like to present this plaque to Tech Force Sergeant Harry L. Ettlinger in gratitude and deep appreciation for your faithful and valuable service as a monument man to this country. God bless you, sir, and thank you.
Thank you, Stephen, for bringing Harry wishes from the Historical Society. As mentioned, this event, including complimentary admission for our courageous veterans and men and women in service, would not be possible without the very generous support of American Legion Post 344. It has been a wonderful, wonderful experience working with the leadership of Post 344, and it's my great pleasure to introduce Post 344 Past Commander Rich Marino.
My name is Rich Marino, as you did mention, I'm a past commander. I'm standing in tonight for our present commander, Russ Hurdy, who unfortunately could not be here with us. I'd like to first off, it's not part of my written speech, but I just wanted to mention driving over here. You know, I just thought about it. But, you know, how often do you meet somebody and get to know somebody that is written in books that actually is several chapters of the monument that And then all of a sudden you see, I'm going to see a motion picture about this person. Probably this is the first and only time in my lifetime that I'll ever experience anything like that. I think that's probably about the same for you folks. At this point, I'd like to recognize a few folks. Would you please hold your, would you please stand? Would you stand, remain standing? And would the rest of the folks please wait until the for the applause at the end? Morris County Veteran Service Officer Charles Jurgensen. Please stand. And for the American Legion, past New Jersey Commander Tony Laurie from Post 155 Whippany. Past New Jersey Commander James Villard from Deadville Post 390. Past New Jersey Commander Harold Libertor from Lincoln Park Post 279. And Morris County Commander Bob Holtz from Forum Park Post 43. In addition, representing Department of New Jersey Commander James Amos is James Conroy, District 1 Department Vice Commander from Chester Post 344. Now I ask that Bob de Blasi and all of Post 344, Legion, Auxiliary, and SAL, please stand. Gentlemen, Legionnaires, your service to our country and to the community, we're so grateful. Tonight we honor a soldier and a veteran, our very own Rockaway Township Monuments Man, Harry Ettlinger. At this time, I believe it's fitting to quote the last paragraph from the Monuments Man, the book. I think it kind of sums things up with Harry. The only visible memento of Harry's war years is a small photograph on a nearby end table. Taken in Heilbronn Mine in early 1946, it shows Monuments Officer Lieutenant Dale Ford and recently promoted Sergeant Harry Ettlinger staring down at a self-portrait of Rembrandt, which you've seen as it circulates. The painting is perched on a mine cart with the rock walls and the steel rails of the mine clearly visible. In 1946, the photograph was used by the Army for promotional purposes and reprinted around the world. The caption said, "American soldiers with a Rembrandt." No one seemed interested in the fact that the painting was a Rembrandt from the museum in Karlsruhe, and that the 19-year-old soldier standing next to it was a German Jew who had grown up three blocks from that museum and by chance had descended several hundred feet to a mine to behold for the first time a painting he had heard about. But under Nuremberg Nazi laws, he never, ever had the right to see. Harry.
I'll turn this back to Peter.
Thank you, Pass Commander Marino. And I am going to ask you if you could stay with us for a moment or two. Again, it's been a real honor to work with you about the Blasi specifically, and we thank the members of the American Legion for their service. And again, if you could please stay with me here, I'd like to introduce our final distinguished guest, and I know you have a joint presentation to make. Our final presenter bringing greetings from the Rockaway Township Governing Body and speaking on behalf of our entire community as we honor Harry is Mayor Michael Datchison. The mayor brings a proclamation from the Township Council and also has a special presentation to make with American Legion Post 344 Past Commander Rich Marino. Mayor.
Thank you.
Welcome. On behalf of myself and the Rockaway Township Council, I thank you all for coming here this evening to pay tribute to this very special man within the Rockaway Township community, Harry Ettlinger. I would like to thank Post 344, Pete Talbot, Joe Ferriello, and countless others who helped bring us together here this evening. I would like to express gratitude to my friends on the council and all the military and political dignitaries that come join us this evening. I would particularly like to thank all of you here today that put on a uniform and served and fought for this great nation, giving me the opportunity and the freedom to be here so I may recognize Mr. Ettlinger's contribution to America and the world's history. I would be remiss if I didn't recognize those veterans here this evening, referred to as the greatest generation. If not for their commitment, their courage, their resolve in the European and South Pacific campaigns, back in the 1940s, Mr. Ettlinger and the Monuments Men would never have the opportunity to recover, document, and return the artifacts to the rightful owners. So I call on Councilman Dr. Gelman, Vice President, to do the proclamation and say a little words because he's a direct contact to the Monuments Men.
Harry's the co-chair of an organization called the Wallenberg Foundation in New Jersey. Raoul Wallenberg was a Swedish citizen who was in Budapest near the end of the war, and it became his work to get Jews out. Hungary was pretty good to Jews at the time of the Second World War. It wasn't until 1944 that we really got in trouble. It's particularly poignant for me as my father's cousin worked for Raoul Wallenberg in Budapest. They used to go out at night and find credentials from Germans. I'll leave the rest up to your imagination. So Harry, a proclamation from the mayor and council. It's actually the mayor's proclamation. Whereas the devastation, intolerance, and hatred wrought by the Nazis during World War II was unparalleled in the history of international conflict, and the very culture of numerous countries was looted, compromised, and potentially lost forever. And whereas the extraordinary men and women of the monuments, fine arts, and archives effort safeguarded countless priceless works of art and cultural heritage, and thereby preserved the richness of European culture, and whereas the deliberate theft of valued objects from their rightful owners and the intentional destruction of the cultural riches during World War II was unprecedented, and the history of ownership for many thousands of priceless cultural artifacts would be lost if not for the work of the monuments, fine arts, and archives efforts. And whereas the issue of provenance or the rightful ownership of valued objects and works of art was advanced due to the work of the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives soldiers. And this contribution established a new precedent for how art, and cultural treasures are to be protected and preserved at times of conflict. And whereas Harry Ettlinger grew up a German Jew during the rise of the Nazi regime in the 1930s and was forced to flee unbearable oppression with his family in 1938, only to return as an enlisted United States infantryman several years later to fight the very oppressors that stole his freedom and had sought to decimate his family's culture. And whereas Harry Ettlinger made invaluable contributions to the efforts of the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives effort, thereby helping ensure the reclamation, restoration, and preservation of the rich objects and artifacts that define cultures. And whereas Harry Ettlinger is one of only five surviving individuals who comprised the Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives efforts out of an original total of 345 from 13 countries, and whereas Harry Ettlinger went on to earn master's degrees in mechanical engineering and business administration, and thereafter continued to protect our country by helping produce guidance systems for submarine launched nuclear weapons, and whereas Harry Ettlinger has remained an active veteran and an advocate against oppression, serving to this day as co-chair of the Wallenberg Foundation, an organization named after an individual that helped rescue 100,000 Hungarian Jews from the Holocaust, and which empowers young people to positively affect society with their individual actions. Now, therefore, I, Councilman Gellman speaking for Mayor Michael Datcherson, by virtue of the authority vested in us by the laws of Rockaway Township, do hereby recognize Harry Ettlinger for his extensive and heroic efforts in helping save and preserve the cultural artifacts of many nations, and urge all residents of Rockaway Township to applaud the inspirational and continued work of this special member of our community. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand this 24th day of February, year of our Lord, 2014, and the independence of the United States of America, the 239th. Signed, Mayor Datcherson.
While we have Past Commander Rich Marino and the Mayor here, there's one more special presentation to Harry before we ask him to share some thoughts with us. So if I could have the Mayor and Rich approach the podium, please. We have here a plaque presented to Harry Ettlinger, Rockaway Township's own Monuments Man. In grateful appreciation for your selfish contributions as a member of the United States Army's Monuments, Fine Arts, and Archives program during World War II, your sacrifice helped save and preserve the culture of millions of future generations. We honor and thank you for your service. February 24, 2004, American Legion Post 344, and Mayor, Council, and citizens of Rockaway Township. I'm going to tell you what a pleasure it's been for myself and our Township Administrator, Greg Poff, for our Director of Community Services, Joe Fiorella, for Captain Marty McParlin. Those of us who got a chance to repeatedly go out to lunch and just spend time listening to Harry's stories. He is absolutely a national treasure, and I'm just so thrilled to be able to call him a friend and just to have spent the time we've spent. He truly, truly, not to be redundant, is a remarkable guy. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Rich, for expressing what so many in attendance tonight feel, and really it's our pride in sharing this community with Harry, and also our pride in the brave veterans and active military in attendance. With any no further ado, it's my great pleasure to bring to the podium our neighbor, our friend, and our guest of honor, Technical Sergeant and Monuments Man, Harry Ettlinger.
is beyond what I happened by brains to find out how many of you show your thank you to my life tonight. It is most unusual for any person to receive such great honors upon from him. And believe me, it makes sure that I spend a couple more years over here alive to this particular community. I want to let you know that it is my goal, for the first time in the history of my family, dating back to 600 years, that a member of my family reaches 100 years. So you're going to have to put up with me for the next one. The other thing that I was thinking about, as all of these honors were bestowed on me tonight, way, way, way beyond anything that I ever expected in my life, I see all of this and I'm saying to myself, Harry, you better get yourself a bigger apartment. I don't have any room anymore on the walls to come along and put this. So if you know of any place, let me know. It obviously, when you, each one of you works and spends many, many, many hours each day in providing, in doing something constructive, and then at the end of the day, at the end of the week, at the end of the month, come home with a little do-re-mi, you know, to make sure that you can come along and have a place to eat, to sleep, as such. I think I'm going to have to find a bigger apartment on it. But it also lets me realize that I've been doing a good job, because if I hadn't, I should have gotten out of the kitchen before this. I think it's a great policy that we Americans and our allies established during World War II, when we said that instead of taking things, instead of taking spoils of war, we saw to it that we give it back to the rightful owner. First time in the history of civilization that a group of countries did something like that, and naturally having been intimately involved in that particular effort, it makes me especially comfortable, proud over here that we did the right thing at the right time for a change that I was involved in, that all Americans were involved in. And your ancestors should be very, very proud of having done this to the rest of the world, preserve the culture of other countries. when they have respected your right, your culture over here, that we live under today, a culture that provides us with the ability to do pleasant things during our days of when we are on this particular earth. And I am, having been more involved in doing that and realizing that sometimes during my lifetime there were groups of evil people who prevented the fact over here of honoring other cultures over here and destroyed them. To me, that's a crime over here that was done to millions and millions of people. The murder of their particular culture is something over here that we hope we should work for to prevent in the future, to prevent the cultures of other people who respect our culture in the future. And I want to thank all of you, my fellow Rockaway residents, for giving me that honor that you have presented to me today.
Again, what a thrill. One more thing before we start the film. By the way, the film has a running time of 1 hour and 59 minutes, in case anybody's wondering. If you could please, just as a courtesy to those around you, silence your cell phones for the film, as you would. We're not going to have a long list of previews. We're going to pretty much go right into the film this evening, but just out of respect. And Joe, take a second. I'm going to ask Joe's help. Again, Joe Fiorella, who helped coordinate this whole thing. So thank you so much, Joe, again. But I'd like you to take this opportunity to ask you to find the raffle tickets you came with. And we'll just do this for a few moments. We want to thank the Monuments Men Foundation and Sony Pictures. And because of that, we have some special gifts this evening, including 5 copies of the Monuments Men book signed by the author, Robert Etzel, whom we've spoken with on the phone, and he wishes he could be here. We have 2 copies of Mr. Etzel's follow-up, Saving Italy, which just came out last year, and those are also signed by the author. And we have some bundles, some nice gifts, including Monuments Men t-shirts, magnets, and journals, in which I suppose you can make notes as you archive your personal collection of art, or your great ideas, or your grocery lists, etc.